Good afternoon and welcome to Saints Peter and Paul this Labor Day weekend. Our parish community wants to welcome in a very special way all new members and any visitors to our parish. Today, we celebrate the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Now please stand and join us in singing our gathering hymn, which can be found on the fourth page of your bulletin.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Yes, our God is here, here within the community too, present to us so he will encourage us to grow in our acceptance and love of one another, and certainly our love of him. Let's acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come now in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, say to those whose hearts are frightened, be strong, fear not. Here is your God. He comes with vindication, with divine recompense. He comes to save you. Then will the eyes of the blind be opened, the ears of the deaf be cleared. Then will the lame leap like a stag. Then the tongue of the mute will sing. Streams will burst forth in the desert and rivers in the steppe. The burning sands will become pools and the thirsty ground springs of water. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. James. My brothers and sisters, show no partiality as you adhere to the faith in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ. For if a man with gold rings and fine clothes comes into your assembly, and a poor person in shabby clothes also comes in, And you pay attention to the one wearing the fine clothes and say, "Sit here, please." Why you say to the poor one, "Stand there," or "Sit at my feet"? Have you not made distinctions among yourselves and become judges with evil designs? Listen, my brothers and sisters, did not God choose those who are poor in the world to be rich in faith and heirs of the kingdom that he promised to those who love him? The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Again, Jesus left the district of Tyre and went by way of Sidon to the Sea of Galilee into the district of the Decapolis. And people brought to him a deaf man who had a speech impediment and begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him off by himself, away from the crowd. He put his finger into the man's ears and, spitting, touched his tongue. Then he looked up to heaven and groaned and said to him, "Ephatha," that is, "be opened." Immediately the man's ears were opened, his speech impediment was removed, and he spoke plainly. He ordered them not to tell anyone. But the more he ordered them not to, the more they proclaimed it. They were exceedingly astonished, and they said, "He has done all things well. He makes the deaf hear and the mute speak." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Makes the deaf hear and the mute speak. It's a phrase that we use every time we have a baptism of an infant. It's really explanatory rites after the baptism takes place, after they're anointed with the sacred chrism, they're vested in the white garment, they receive the candle that symbolizes the light of Christ, which they had received through baptism, and then the priest comes. And it used to be you would do the very things that Jesus did, certainly not putting fingers in the ear, but touching the ear. The Lord Jesus made the deaf hear, and then touching the mouth. It used to be that they spit, you know, COVID and all the rest. People get a little bit nervous about that. But you can sense the ideas that from the very beginning of our life in Christ, what's happening? We're understanding and remembering what he did physically for this man. The very same words are used, "Ephatha." Now, we're not usually there at the preliminary rites for the adult baptisms. That always takes place in the morning of Holy Saturday. And we have a prayer service, and the scriptures are read, and this is one of the scriptures that we read. And the very thing, touching the ears and the mouth, speaking those words, Ephata, be opened. So we can understand that the gospel is helping us see the sign that was truly performed, but we realize that Mark helps us to see there's more to it. He wants us to see the deeper reality that's taking place. First of all, he sets it in the geography of making sure we understood that this territory that Jesus was going into was mostly Gentile. In fact, they mentioned the name Tyre, and then he's talking about this little machinations of where Jesus is going. It's like Mark wants to help the church understand the movement of the gift of faith will be not just to the Jewish communities, but through Christ, the door will be swung open, you see, to those too who are Gentile. That will be a challenging time for the early church to deal with, which we heard last week when it talked about all things are made clean. You know, the difficulty of what you could eat and have to wash your hands and all the ritual kinds of cleansings that were done. But this is a part of Mark trying to help us. Now, there's a miracle that happened just before this. It was that Syrophoenician woman. She was a Gentile, and her daughter was troubled by a demon. And she came to Jesus asking for him to come and lay his hand on her to cure her of that infestation of evil. Remember the kind of the dialogue that went on there? He says, well, you know, really, basically, I can't throw the food of the children to the dogs. And she says, well, wait a minute. They even get to eat the scraps that fall. Remember that story? It's a powerful one. But the point being that she was not a Jewish person. And God's love working through Christ brought healing to her home, freed her and her household from this enslavement they had, the troubling of this demon that was bothering the family, and certainly her child. Gentile territory, Christ comes, he heals, he frees, right? These are the gifts that he's bringing. And so right here again, with this particular lesson of this deaf man, I notice that it says that when he came into this territory, okay, the people brought him. I don't know who those people are. Didn't say they were good Jewish people. The people brought him, and sometimes they're going to identify in some ways. It's kind of what reminds me of that story, too, in the gospel about the paralyzed man. There were the men who carried him on a litter. Remember, they couldn't get in because of the crowd, and they went up on the roof and opened it up and let him down in front of Jesus, and Jesus saw their faith. When I think about this, well, there are folks that don't seem to be hearing the word of God or being able to express in any way an act of faith. What are we doing about it? These people brought the man to Jesus. Now, he didn't get a chance to ask himself, did he? He couldn't speak. But a matter of fact, they cared enough to bring him to Christ. Well, you know, the Lord sends his disciples out in order for that to happen in the world. So we can be the ones who see the need of people being able to hear the word of God. Impaired as he was, now we can see he took him off by himself. Placing his fingers in it, it's very symbolic, isn't it? Kind of unplugging, all right? And the same thing of the freeing of the tongue to be able to express in faith, this act of faith. Well, over and over again, I'm reminded, during the weekdays, we've been reading now from Luke's gospel, but maybe you recall the scene that he went to his hometown, Nazareth, and he was handed the scroll of the prophet Isaiah. Well, we have a little part of the prophet Isaiah tonight, don't we? And that little part mentions something about encouraging the people to realize that in exile as they are, God can look upon their in their difficult, challenging situation, their poverty, if you will, separated from temple and their hometowns and the priests and all the rest of those kinds of things. And he's promising something that's going to happen. He wants them to know he cares about them, especially because in their poverty, spiritual poverty at the moment, the struggling that they've gone through, And what does he use the imagery in Isaiah today? Yes, the eyes of the blind will be open, and the ears of the deaf be made clean. We hear the sign of the presence of the Messiah, the one whom God has sent, the Christ, the anointed one. So we might look, too, about how we hearing the word. What's keeping us from hearing that word? That's so important. I think there's a little effort now going around to try to help families prepare their children for the Sunday celebration. Maybe being able to read over that gospel before they come to church, so that as we come and hear it proclaimed, we're going, oh, I heard that before. Now, what does it mean? You know, that's another step along the journey, isn't it? Hmm? But as a matter of fact, it's like, well, what is God doing here by giving us this particular lesson and helping the children to kind of prepare their hearts and their minds for what God is going to open up to them? Then we have to learn how to apply it. See? I think one of the questions this particular Sunday would be, wonder what the first words of that man were. He hasn't been able to hear. He hasn't been able to speak. He's hearing sounds that he's never heard before. He's hearing words that he doesn't even maybe understand. Matter of fact, what would he say? You see, the Lord is reaching out to this man in this desperate situation. It wasn't anything life-threatening, but certainly it kept him from what? Life, okay? And yet he's receiving this gift. And we can see that he becomes a sign to the other people. Amazement. Amazement. They couldn't stop talking about it. They couldn't stop sharing the story with other people. They wanted to announce this good news of God's presence to this poor man. God did for him. Judged by the community, he is unclean, and yes, and he was disabled, and so he was not among. Oh. Christ changes that. Wants us to be able to see others, wherever kind of a situation in life. You notice what St. James was talking about? You know, the rich man comes in with all the fancy garb on, and then the other guy comes in all rags and torn, and how are you treating them? Your response. Do we hear the word of God saying to us? And what are we saying? We just ask the Lord for that grace. We want him to open us up to the mystery of that love that is all-inclusive, does reach out, and it doesn't judge and categorize people because of their status. No. The Lord bless us. May he help guide us. May he enrich our lives in every way. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. Crucified under Pontius Pilate,
he suffered death and was buried,
and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I can confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, it is you who have sent your Son to truly open us to the mystery and marvel of your holy word. For it is the truth, it is life, and we turn to you now with our petitions and prayers.
That the whole church and its leaders will be filled with the power of the Spirit to proclaim the good news of Christ, opening the ears and lives of all peoples of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders will use resources and power to bring people together, especially the poor and marginalized, healing past wounds and securing peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our parish family will dedicate itself to helping all of us to be able to hear the word of Christ and fully live it through prayer, sincere hospitality, generous serving, and giving, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be a community open to all people, regardless of their economic or social status, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick will know the compassion and the healing presence of Christ in this community and through the sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died will soon be gathered at the banquet feast of heaven with special prayers for Ella Loyett and Bill Graham, also Kathy Murphy and Roy Scoggins, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, we heard how your Son opened the ears of the man who was deaf, so he could truly hear the word of God. Open our hearts. Help us to hear and listen, to embrace, and to live fully what he has taught us, truly sharing the gift of his love with all, that we can be gathered into the banquet of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Right and just.
it is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became a neighbor to the oppressed and to the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Peter and Paul, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him,
O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Who cannot now receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer the following prayer. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit me not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you nourish and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. There's still time to sign up and have your family photo taken for our new parish directory, so please stop by the table in the gathering space for more information and sign up. Knights of Columbus raffle tickets are still available at the welcome desk in the gathering space. And again, the tickets are $50, and you can win free school tuition or $3,500 cash. Sign up for a time slot in our parish's Day of Prayer in the 40 Days for Life campaign in the gathering space as well. If you have questions, contact Diane Hill for more information. And finally, if you or someone you know is experiencing the sorrow of recently losing a loved one, consider joining the next session of our Seasons of Hope Grief Support Group. See the bulletin for more information on how to sign up.
Well, thank you, Nick. Appreciate that. Well, we continue to praise the Lord for allowing us to gather, and we notice how the numbers have increased in the country and how people are talking about trying to encourage others for vaccines. You hear the stories of individual families and lives. So again, I extend that invitation to you to consider that, to pray about it, asking the Lord's guidance for you and for the safety and well-being of yourself, family, and others around you. Are there special announcements I didn't make? We'll have a good holiday. A little time. It looks like rainy the first day and maybe a couple of days of nice enjoyment. So enjoy that time. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.